Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student. Welcome to Vastech channel. So we will continue our discussion related to reliable data transfer protocol. In the last session or last video, you have seen we have discussed reliable data transfer over perfect reliable channel, that is RDT 1.0, protocol RDT 1.0. That is, we assume that channel is reliable, perfectly reliable. There is no data loss. In this session, we will see channel is not reliable. Channel may be subject to error during a transmission, that is called as a bit error. Some of the bits may get corrupted, and the protocol related to this one is called as RDT 2.0. Please remember, RDT 2.0 also called as Automatic Repeat Request Protocol, ARQ, Automatic Repeat Request Protocol, ARQ. So also, there is some behavior of RDT 2.0. Because of that, it's also called as stop and wait protocol. So in the exam, ARQ and stop and wait protocol is nothing but RDT 2.0. So before proceeding, you see some of the question related to this one here. What is the meaning of positive and negative acknowledgement? List the three possibilities for handling corrupted ACK, NACK in RDT protocol, that is related to 2.0. With the help of FSM, describe two states of the sender side and one state of the receiver side in RDT 2.0. These are the questions they may ask in the exam. So we will proceed to this one now. So before proceeding, how do human recovers from errors during the conversation? As I said in my previous video, you just think there is a message detector who detects the long message, and the message taker who takes the message. As soon as he receives the message, that means he hears the message properly, then he will record the message and he will say okay. If the message has not been heard properly, then he say repeat please. So here okay and repeat please, with respect to network context, it is called as positive acknowledgement and negative acknowledgement. Okay is nothing but positive acknowledgement, and repeat please is nothing but negative acknowledgement. So our RDT 2.0 or automatic repeat request or stop and wait. I repeat all these words several times to make you familiar with these terms. All these protocols mean same protocols. RDT 2.0 uses feedback, that is nothing but control message. You can see here, that is nothing but control message. ACK and NACK. ACK is called as positive acknowledgement, NACK is called as negative acknowledgement. Other than that, it will adopt a certain mechanism for error detection. So this is behind RDT 1.0, where RDT 1.0 is a perfect channel without any data loss, but RDT 2 is for a channel with the bit errors. So we'll proceed now. So you see, the FSM of RDT In the FSM of RDT20, it has got two state from the sender side and the receiver side is only one state. So we'll see how this works now. Sender side, you can see the FSM. And please remember, this is the event. Let me mark, this is the event for your reference. This is the action taken. This is the FSM state. This is the wait state and this is wait for acknowledgement. That means this is wait for the data from the upper layer. This is wait for the acknowledgement from the receiver. Similarly, a receiver wait for the data from the sender. So now we'll proceed this one with this. How this works, we'll see. So first, RDT operation with no errors. We'll see now RDT operation with no errors. So sender, there is event and it is waiting for a call from the above. That means it is waiting for the data from the above layer, the application layer. As soon as the data comes, RDT send event is activated. RDT send event will do certain action, that is RDT send event followed by the action taken. Something like it will create the packet and the packet by using make packet, and the make packet contains the variables data and checksum. So that means it will calculate the checksum also, and it will use UDT underscore send and it will send the packet. And after that, it will move from wait for call from the above to wait for acknowledgement state. And it will loop here. Till how long? That we have to see. Now we will complete this side. Suppose if receives acknowledgement packet and it is a negative acknowledgement, then it will call the event, it will call the action or event that is RDT send. It will resend the packet. If there is no error, that means it received the packet and the packet is acknowledgement packet and it is proper, then no action is taken, then it will move to the wait state. Once again, it will wait for the data. That is this one. On the receiver side, it will wait for the data from this sender. Suppose just imagine the received data, it has received data and it is corrupted. What it will do? It will send the negative acknowledgement saying that the data is corrupted. Please repeat. And it will loop here only. And if it received data and not corrupt, then it will extract the data. This is the event. This is extract the data. And it will pass that data to the deliver underscore data event, and it will call one more event that will send the acknowledgement here. So in this way it works. So we'll see now. See, both side waiting for the call and both side waiting for call and waiting for call from below. Now, when the data is there, packet is created, packet is sent, and packet is received, and there is no data error, packet is extracted, and acknowledgement is sent, as I explained. Second scenario, error scenario. Once again, wait for call, packet is created, packet is sent, and error, then it will... Once again, receiver will request for resend by using negative acknowledgement, and sender will send. This time, packet is received properly, no error, and packet is data is extracted, and acknowledgement is sent. So in this way, it works. So now, my dear students, what are the disadvantages of RDT 2.0 that we have to discuss? From the exam point of view, very, very important. So before proceeding, you see this one. I have explained you what is the meaning of positive and negative acknowledgement. Now, list the three possibilities of handling corrupted ACK NACK in RDT protocol. So now you see here, so now students, we'll see what happens if ACK and NACK corrupted. That means, we'll take the old example, message detector. He has sent the message and our message taker sends as replied saying okay or please repeat. If this is corrupted, now what is the solution for this one? Sender doesn't know what happened at the receiver. And sender received garbled data, that is ACK and NACK. So what is the possibility? Sender has to just retransmit and that will result in duplicate packets. Are you getting my points? Receiver is sending acknowledgement and or negative acknowledgement. Suppose if that is corrupted, that is message taker says okay or please repeat. If that is corrupted, how the sender will come to know what has happened with the receiver side? No chance. He got just a garbled packet. So what he has to do now? One possibility is he has to retransmit the packet. But receiver has already, suppose you take ACK, receiver has already, just you take in this example, receiver has sent ACK and ACK is corrupted. What is the meaning of ACK? That receiver has received the packet properly. That is the meaning of ACK. And ACK is corrupted. Now sender doesn't know what has happened. Now one alternative is he will retransmit. If he retransmit, receiver will get the same packet and that is nothing but duplicate. So what one is, that is the one possibility. Third one is, if the ACK and NACK corrupted, or if the receiver says okay, please repeat. If this one is garbled, the sender may say, what did you say? If the sender has not listened properly, he may say, what did you say? Now the question, if that what did you say is corrupted, then what the receiver has to do? All these are the different disadvantages of our RDT 2.0. So how to handle this one? Handle this one is retransmitting the packet that may which is corrupted, that is relay, that will relay, that will results in duplicate packet. So how to handle now duplicate packet? To handle duplicate packet, TCP has one more field in the TCP header that is called as a sequence number. So while sending the each packet, sender will send the packet along with the sequence number, and as soon as the receiver receives the sequence number, particular sequence number, he has to acknowledgement for that one, and you will come to know by seeing the sequence number whether the packet is a duplicate packet or not. So this is also called a stop and wait protocol, because your sender sends one packet, then waits for the receiver response. Then after that, you will send one more packet. This way it's called a stop and wait. This is also one solution for handling the disadvantages of RDT 2.0. And one more thing is, to handle RDT 2.0, that is corrupted ACK or NACK, what the receiver can do is, just imagine ACK and NACK is corrupted. So if the receiver sends the data with more checksum, so that sender can try to detect the error and correct the error, then that is the immediate solution. So in the exam, if they ask the disadvantage, because most of the time questions can be asked in several ways. There won't be a direct questions in this chapter. So if the sender asks like this, then you can answer the advantage of RDT 2, disadvantages of RDT 2, and advantages of RDT 2 over RDT 1 we already know. So how to overcome the disadvantages of RDT 2.0? That we have RDT 2.1. RDT 2.1. In RDT 2.1, you can see here, sequence number is used. RDT 2.1 sequence number is used. You can see here, see RDT 2.1 sequence number is used. For example, let me explain this one. Waiting for the data, waiting for the data from the upper layer, then create the packet. While creating the packet, use the sequence number, data, checksum, send. After that, move into the other state. This is the sender. So on receiving a packet, on receiving packet and the packet is found to be corrupted, then resend. Otherwise, move to once again state one more state where it will create the packet with the sequence number 1, data, checksum, send it, wait for the acknowledgement, that is wait for ACK or NACK 1 here wait for ACK or NACK 0. If it is NACK, then repeat it. If it is proper, then over, then once again 0. So only two sequence number is sufficient in stop and wait, 0 and 1. So in this way 2.1 will work. In this way 2.1 will work. So RDT 2.0, please remember RDT 2.0, NACK is there, ACK is there, but in RDT 2.1 we are using sequence numbers along with NACK and ACK. So RDT 2.1, how the receiver handles? So RDT 2.1, how the receiver handles? See, suppose receiver is waiting for the data. If the data is received and not corrupt and sequence number 0, fine. Extract, deliver it to the upper layer. Make packet. What is that make packet? Why receiver has to make packet? Receiver has to send the acknowledgement. For that packet is required. Acknowledgement. And don't just send the acknowledgement. You send the acknowledgement with the checksum. Then send the packet. Then after that, wait for one. Sequence number 1. So suppose once again here also, error. Then send negative acknowledgement. Otherwise, one more possibility. Here you are waiting for 0 and you received, you are waiting for 1 and you received 0. The packet is correct, but you have received 0. That is a duplicate this one packet. Then yeah, correct. You have received 0. On the receiver received 0. Already has received 0. Once again, he has received 0. That means a duplicate acknowledgement. Just inform with the ACK 0. So he will come to know. Once again, ACK 0 means 2 times. So he has already sent ACK. Once again, ACK 0 means he will come to know. So otherwise, if he receives proper packet, that is sequence number 1, and it is not corrupted, then extract the data, deliver the data to deliver event, and send packet, make packet, acknowledgement packet, and checksum, send not only acknowledgement, send the checksum for that acknowledgement also, then send it. For example, other than that, here also you can see in wait 0, he has received corrupted this one, then resend it. Or he has received other than that, he is waiting for the acknowledgement 0, but he has received the acknowledgement 1, then it is a duplicate packet. Same thing what I explained this side, I will repeat here also. So this is the how a receiver works. So in RDT 2.1, you have to study. If you understand this one exact logic, then you can write like, sometimes words here and there will happen while writing, but if you understand the logic, you can write. So you have to remember here in 2.1, There are sender section and a receiver section also, receiver also, and both has got two state, 0 and 1, and you can see here in the diagram. So with this, we completed 2.1. Now, what is the difference between 2.1 and 2.2? You have one more thing, 2.2. 2.2 is, will not use negative acknowledgement. See, I have received packet. Just think, you are sending me packet. You are sending me packet. The number what you sent is 2. I have received 2. Next time you will send 3. And 3 is... I will receive the 3, but it will corrupt. It is not proper. That time, what I will do? I will send negative acknowledgement. Instead of that, I will send a positive acknowledgement only, saying that I have received 2. That will give clear indication to you that I have not received a 3. Clear? So that is the one speciality of RDT 2.2, where it is not using negative acknowledgement. So we'll see now here. RDT, before the moving to RDT 2.2, we will see here RDT 2.1 sequence number is used two sequence number, why we know, and must check if received acknowledgement or corrupted. Then all these things we have discussed here. Then RDT 2.2 NAC free protocol. As I said, instead of NAC, receiver sends ACK for the last packet received. So duplicate ACK at the sender results in the same action. So you can see here FSM. So you see the FSM here. Let me explain FSM. So this is wait for 0. RDT send data. RDT send data. Yeah, if the packet comes, make the packet with the 0. What is that? Sequence number. Data. Then checksum for data, right? Then send it. And move into wait state for acknowledgement. Here wait state for data. Wait state for acknowledgement. So now it is waiting for acknowledgement 0. Now here we'll move to the receiver session. Wait for 0. It is waiting for the sequence number 0. If it is properly received 0, yeah, let me explain, let me complete this one. Here you see the sender and receiver fragments, it is not shown completely. So here is waiting for the acknowledgement 0. Suppose he has received, sender has received the packet and it is corrupted. That is the one case. Received the packet and corrupted, or he has received the packet and that is just like a corrupted, or he has received the acknowledgement, proper acknowledgement. Here also it is acknowledgement only, here also it is acknowledgement, but here acknowledgement is corrupted, here acknowledgement is received, but the acknowledgement shows sequence number 1. That means he is waiting for sequence number 0 acknowledgement, right? UDT send once again. Otherwise, he has received the packet. What is the packet? Packet is nothing but acknowledgement. And that is proper, not corrupted. And it is 0 only. So for the sequence number 0 only, no action. It will move to sequence number 1. It is not shown here. That doesn't mean in the exam, you have to show that one. So in the exam, you have to draw a full diagram, like 2.1 what you have drawn, same type of diagram you have to draw and you have to show. So here you see, waiting for the acknowledgement, waiting for the packet. So suppose he has received the packet, but it is corrupt. Or he has received, but it's sequence number 1. Now like packet is not in order, different packet. Or old packet, that means recent. Otherwise he has otherwise it will, it is, if it is proper, it will move to wait for 1. in the one in the way, wait for one, if he received the proper acknowledgement, then he will move to wait for zero. This is RDT 2.2. So in the exam, this is the fragment. If you write fragment, better write for a proper diagram in the exam. So now the next one is RDT 3.0. That is the next one. That is channel with the errors and loss. So all these things you will see in the next session. Thank you for watching VASTEC channel. Thank you.